Do you want to paint outside but don't know where to start from? Don't worry. In this video, I will take you through my plein air watercolor setup and I will also cover my top 5 tips for painting outdoors. So make sure that you stick around till the end. I ordered this easel about a year ago from Amazon. It is really lightweight. Weighs only 2 kilograms. It has a sturdy tripod. Comes with a board to keep my paper on. And a mixing palette board. This easel is so simple to set up, takes me only 3 minutes. I use 2 kinds of palettes for outdoor painting, Winsor & Newton and John Pike. Winsor & Newton is my travel palette and John Pike is my studio palette. If I am painting close to my apartment, I usually end up carrying my John Pike palette. After my easel is set up, I start placing my watercolor paper on the board. I usually don't tape my paper, but when I'm painting outdoors, I use a tape. Also, I just carry 3 or 4 brushes for plein air painting. I don't use an old rag or tissue to wipe my brushes. Instead, I use this sponge, which can absorb up to 300 milliliters of water. And that's it. That's all you need to get started. There's one more thing. I recently invested in a chair as I don't like standing for too long. I will post the product links in the description below. I also wanted to mention that if I'm traveling outside of my home country, I currently live in Amsterdam, I don't carry my easel, and that's because of my personal preference of traveling light with only a carry-on bag. Okay, so that was my easy plein air setup. It's time to talk about my top 5 tips for painting outdoors. At the end of this video, I will give you a bonus tip, so make sure you watch it till the end. My first and the most important tip for you is to always keep water and snack. I can't think on an empty stomach. And watercolor requires a lot of planning and thinking. I always keep a granola bar or a sandwich to keep me going for at least 2 or 3 hours. My second tip is related to weather. If you are in a tropical country, you need to protect yourself by wearing a sunscreen, glasses, and a hat. Make sure you're wearing comfortable clothes and shoes. Also, it's best to choose a location where there's shade. If you are at a colder location, make sure you're dressed in layers to tackle the cold and the wind. My third tip is to paint something simple or, let's say, ordinary. You might be standing in front of the Taj Mahal or the Eiffel Tower and might be tempted to paint. Don't get me wrong, there's no harm in doing so, but most often than not, you will be frustrated with the results. Instead, walk around, find something ordinary that catches your eye and paint something simple. It will give you immense satisfaction. Go easy on yourself. My fourth tip is about finding a place to sit. Many people are comfortable standing for 2 or 3 hours, but I cannot. So I bought this foldable chair. It is easy to carry and fits properly in my bag. You can also sit in your car and paint or find a bench in a park. My last tip is about onlookers. You will definitely encounter people who are interested in knowing what you're up to. I am a social person. I like talking to strangers. When someone approaches me, I give them my attention. If I'm between washes, I tell them how long I'll take and if they want to wait. If you don't like to be bothered, there are several things you can do. You can put earplugs and pretend that you're listening to music. Or you can stand in a position where people can't bother you, or just don't make any eye contact with people.
Alright, so these were my top 5 tips to make your day a little more tolerable and plan your experience a little more enjoyable. I have so many other tips when it comes to painting outdoors. Perhaps I can make another video.
If you can relate to any of these 5 tips, please leave a comment below and let me know about your experiences.
Now it's time for a bonus tip. If you're just starting out, it's best to find a friend or a plein air group with whom you can paint. I personally enjoy painting alone as I can work at my own pace. Plein air painting or painting outdoors is not easy. Even though it's very rewarding, it can be frustrating. I remember my first time, I was so upset with the mosquitoes. There you go, another tip, carry a mosquito repellent. Apparently, Icelanders won't need any because there are no mosquitoes in Iceland. Alright, that's all for today. If you're new here, please don't forget to like and subscribe. See you soon.